never been. We're gonna ride the sky high in this sanctuary of sin. I come from a place deeper than thought has ever been, way before the beginning could begin. Time transcends time. Time transcends time. I forged a key from a place far worse than hell. I have ideas of love and peace that I keep in a jail cell. In a world of a low goodbye where men aren't supposed to cry. An angel rules the sky. Love will never die. Time transcends time. Time transcends time. Was the genius that wrote the song of victory. Teetering on insanity, his enigma will make history. His genius was his ignorance of the mind. He saw the truth when he was blind. Time transcends time. Time transcends time. From what I wasn't supposed to do. I was built by the obstacles God put me through. I was the question and the answer, the dull and the shine, the wolf running on water, a sign that would be mine. Time transcends time. I'm the fire in the sky that fights the evil of darkness. I'm the heart of compassion, the child of forgiveness. I fell from building blocks of puzzles and rhyme. I had to fall to understand the climb. Gonna take you somewhere that you've never been. I come from a place deeper than thought has ever been. Way before the beginning could begin. Time transcends time. Time transcends time. What happens when evil marries love? The president's a puppet. The cop's a thug. Confession is a hoax. The minister's a mime, and I'm the outlaw with this prophetic rhyme. Time transcends time. Time transcends time. There's a hate between me and control. There's a wall standing tall between the dark and my soul. I was the hand in the climb, the moral in the crime. I'm the alchemist that spun my tears to wine. Time transcends time. A messenger of love. An artist of the sublime. An artist of the sublime. An artist of the sublime.
Kärleksbrev från din far till dig. De orden som du kommer att höra här, de är sanna. Och de kommer att förändra ditt liv om du tillåter det. För de orden kommer ifrån Guds hjärta till dig. Han älskar dig och han är den pappan som du har letat efter hela ditt liv. Och detta är hans kärleksbrev till dig. Mitt barn, du kanske inte vet vem jag är, men jag vet allt om dig. Jag vet när du sitter och när du står. Jag känner till allt du gör. Till och med varje hårstrå på ditt huvud är räknad. För till min avbild blev du skapad. I mig du lever och rör dig och är till. För du är min avkomling. Jag kände dig redan innan, när du inte ens var bildad i moderlivet. Jag valde dig då jag planerade skapelsen. Du är inget misstag, därför att alla dina dagar var redan skrivna i min bok. Jag fastställde en bestämd tid för din födelse och var du skulle bo. Du är underbar skapad. Jag vävde dig i moderlivet. Från din första stund har jag varit ditt stöd. De som inte känner mig gjorde felaktiga bilder av mig. Jag är inte långt borta ifrån dig eller arg på dig, utan jag är den fullkomliga kärleken. Och det är mitt begär att få ge dig min kärlek, bara därför att du är mitt barn och jag är din far. Jag erbjuder dig mer än din jordiska fader kan någonsin erbjuda dig. Därför att jag är den fullkomliga fadern. Varje fullkomlig gåva som du får kommer ifrån min hand. För jag är din försörjare och möter alla dina behov. Min plan för din framtid har alltid varit fylld med hopp. Jag älskar dig med evig kärlek. Mina tankar om dig är lika tallösa som sandkornen på stranden. Jag fröjder mig över dig med jubel. Jag vill aldrig sluta att göra dig gott. För du är min dyrbaraste skatt och egendom. Av hela mitt hjärta och all min själ önskar jag att du ska slå rot. Och jag vill visa dig stora och förunderliga ting. Om du söker mig med hela ditt hjärta ska du finna mig. Ha din lust i mig och jag vill ge dig vad ditt hjärta begär. För det var jag som gav dig denna önskan. Jag förmår göra långt mer än du kan någonsin föreställa dig. För jag är din största uppmuntran. Jag är också fadern som tröstar dig i alla dina svårigheter. Jag hör dig och räddar dig ur all din nöd. Som en herde bär ett lam. På samma sätt bar jag dig tätt in till mitt hjärta. En dag jag ska torka alla dina tårar ifrån dina ögon. Och all smärta jag ska ta bort ifrån dig som du har lidit på den här jorden. Jag är din far och jag älskar dig liksom jag älskar min son Jesus. För min kärlek till dig är uppenbarad i Jesus. Han är ett avbild av mitt väsen. Han kom för att visa dig att jag är för dig och inte är emot dig. Och för att meddela att jag räknar inte längre dina synder. Jesus gav sitt liv för att du och jag kan försonas. Hans död var den yttersta uttrycket av min kärlek till dig. Jag gav upp det jag älskade för att vinna din kärlek. Om du tar emot min son Jesus, så tar du också emot mig. Och ingenting ska någonsin kunna skilja dig från min kärlek. Vänd om och kom hem. Och jag skulle en sådan fest i himlen som aldrig någon någonsin har sett förut. Jag har alltid varit din far. Alltid kommer att förbli din far. Min fråga är: vill du vara mitt barn? Jag väntar på dig. Kära hälsningar från din far, den allsmäktige guden. Han natt hade en man en dröm. Han drömde om att han gick längs en strand tillsammans med Gud. På himlen trädde plötsligt scener från hans liv fram. Han märkte att varje scen började med spår i sanden av två par fötter. Det ena spåret var hans och det andra var Guds. När den sista scenen av hans liv framträdde såg han tillbaka på fotspåren i sanden. Han märkte att under sin levnadsvandring fanns det bara ett par fotspår. Han märkte också att det inträffade under hans mest ensamma och svåra perioder av sitt liv. Det bekymrade honom verkligen och han frågade Gud om detta. Herre, du sa den gången jag bestämde mig för att följa dig att du skulle aldrig överge mig utan att gå vid min sida hela vägen. Men jag har märkt att under de allra svåraste tiderna i mitt liv har det funnits bara ett par fotspår. Jag kan inte förstå det. Att du lämnade mig när jag behövde dig som mest. Herren svarade honom. Min kära son, min dyra barn, jag älskar dig. Och jag har aldrig lämnat dig. Under de tiderna av prövningar och lidande, när du såg bara ett par fotspår i sanden, det var då jag bar dig. Du är min styrka när jag inte har. Du är mina fötter när jag inte kan gå. Tack min Herre och Gud, Jesus, för din uppoffring.
The Bible says my king is the king of the Jews. He's a king of Israel. He's a king of righteousness. He's a king of the ages. He's a king of heaven. He's a king of glory. He's the king of kings. And he's the Lord of lords. That's my king. I wonder, do you know him? My king is a sovereign king. No means of measure can define his limitless love. He's enduringly strong. He's entirely sincere. He's eternally steadfast. He's immortally graceful. He's imperially powerful. He's impartially merciful. Do you know him? He's the greatest phenomenon that has ever crossed the horizon of this world. He's God's son. He's a sinner's savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's unparalleled. He's unprecedented. He is the loftiest idea in literature. He's the highest personality in philosophy. He's the fundamental doctrine of true theology. He's the only one qualified to be an all-sufficient savior. I wonder if you know him today. He supplies strength for the weak. He's available for the tempted and the tried. He sympathizes and he saves. He strengthens and sustains. He guards and he guides. He heals the sick. He cleanses the land. lepers. He forgives sinners. He discharges debtors. He delivers the captive. He defends the feeble. He blesses the young. He serves the unfortunate. He regards the aged. He rewards the diligent. And he purifies the meek. I wonder if you know him. He's a key to knowledge. He's a wellspring of wisdom. He's a doorway of deliverance. He's a pathway of peace. He's a roadway of righteousness. He's a highway of holiness. He's a gateway of glory. Do you know him? Well, his life is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. And his yoke is easy. And his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you. He's indescribable. He's incomprehensible. He's invincible. He's irresistible. Well, you can't get him out of your mind. You can't get him off of your hand. You can't outlive him, and you can't live without him. Well, the Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they found out they couldn't stop him. Pilate couldn't find any fault in him. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him, and the grave couldn't hold him. Yeah.
He looks at you and he says this, Father, such is my love to this one person and my pity for them. After they've broken every command, he still says, such is my love and such is my pity. Proud men say, I don't want your pity. You need his pity. You need his pity. We are pitiful. He says, such is my love to and pity for them, that rather than they shall perish eternally, I will be responsible for them as their guarantee. Bring in all thy bills, Father, that I may see what they owe thee. Now, sometimes a young man will get married, and after he gets married, he'll start getting a little shaky on his commitment. He said, I had no idea marriage was this tough. I don't know if this is really what I'm made to do. You see, he was boasting about how much he would love this girl. He had no idea the commitment he was going to have to make. But that is not true with Christ. Here he says to the Father, Father, bring in everything they owe thee. Let me see it. Imagine this. He sees everything that you owe justice. He doesn't go to that cross blindly. He doesn't get on the cross and say, no, Father, I don't want to do this. I didn't know it would cost so much. He knew from eternity how much it would cost him, and yet he still did it. But listen to this. Bring in all thy bills that I may see what they owe thee. Lord, bring them all in. Now listen, believers, if this doesn't make you so happy, you weep or cry out for joy, you're not understanding what I'm saying. He says, bring in all the bills. Bring them all in that there may be no after reckonings with them. Do you see what he's saying? Bring in every one of their bills from the time they were born to the time they die. Everything they owe thee, Father. Bring them all in. I want to see them all, and on that tree, I want to pay for them all there so that you never have to deal with them again with regard to their sin. Do you see that, believer? He never has to deal with you again. It's over. All your crimes are paid for. Your crimes in the past, your crimes in the present, your crimes you're going to commit in the future, all of them paid for. And some people say, well, if you tell that to people, they'll just sin. No, they won't. Not true believers. Carnal, wicked, lost church members will hear that and go on sinning. But believers will say, if His love is like that, if He has set me free completely, I'm His. I don't want to sin anymore. I don't want to sin anymore. You see, brothers, that's what leads to holiness. That's why the gospel is called the mystery of godliness. You see that? It's the thing that produces godliness in the believer. Yes, there are commands and there are rules, but that's not what makes us godly. What makes us godly is knowing that Jesus died and that He died for me. And when He died, He paid for every sin, past, present, and future. And God will never again, never call me into His judgment hall to judge me. Never again. I'm free. I'm free. Oh, thank God I'm free. And you say, but Brother Paul, it says that there's going to be a judgment for a believer. Yeah, but listen to this. In that judgment, when you look up into the judge's face, it will be your father. It will be your brother. The one who judges you is the one who died for you. Don't you see that? You're free. You're free. No guilt. Always come to Him. Always go back to Him. Always run to Him. You're free. You finally walked through a door that no one in this world knows anything about. It's unconditional love. You're just loved, and it can't be changed now. Because of that perfect work of Christ on that tree, on your behalf. Christ so loved you, so loved His bride, that He, who was ruler of all things, the heir of the universe and beyond, He became a servant because of His love for His bride, because of His love for you as individuals.
Jacob was wandering through the region of Haran when all of a sudden he saw Rachel. And immediately he knew she had to be his. So he volunteered to work 7 long years in exchange for her hand. Only problem was, after 7 long years, he was given the wrong girl. Leah. So Jacob set out to work another 7 long years to get his Rachel. Love will make you do crazy things. Hosea was a prophet with one unique calling from God. Marry that prostitute, God said. Now Gomer was not the ideal wife. She ran away, she gave herself to other men, but Hosea had a calling. And no matter how many times she ran away, no matter how many men she gave herself to, Hosea still loved her. Love will make you do crazy things. King Solomon had a good head on his shoulders, a smart guy, the wisest that ever lived, they say. But nothing could stop him from losing his mind every time he saw his beloved. He screamed of his love from the mountaintop. He shouted his devotion in the valley. He even wrote it all down and let millions of people read it. Love will make you do crazy things. So it's no wonder the Bible calls us the bride of Christ. And from the beginning of time, Christ has been pursuing His bride, pursuing her beyond the walls of the garden, beyond her disobedience, pursuing her in the midst of her rebellion, in spite of her wickedness, pursuing her to the lands of foreign gods in the midst of her unfaithfulness, because our disobedience to God's will can never outweigh Christ's obedience to it. Our wickedness can never outweigh his goodness. Our unfaithfulness can never outweigh his faithfulness. We give ourselves to other gods, but he still loves his bride. He shouts of his love for us through every word written in the scriptures, and he pursues us to immeasurable lengths, even death on a cross, because with Christ, it isn't till death do us part. It is only through his death that we have assurance that we will never part from him, and we will spend eternity together. Love will make you do crazy things. This is more than a metaphor.